Download and listen to our podcast and subscribe to our newsletter. You can also go to iHeartMedia.com to listen live or download the free iHeartRadio app and listen to us from anywhere in the world. A big shout out again to our sponsors, great companies like Sun Warrior, Squatty Potty, the H-Hump Company, Paleo Magazine, the Wellbeing Journal, and the International Society of Sports Nutrition. Okay, DeWone, let's go. Let's debate. Okay.
I'm ready. I'm ready.
And by the way, everyone, if you haven't voted yet, get out there and vote. It's the American thing to do. It's the right thing to do because you've got no right to, you know what, about anything unless you've gotten out there and voted. So this is a difficult subject. Let me introduce you properly before we begin. DeWone Bennett is a licensed professional counselor with over 11 years of counseling experience from Vallejo, California. DeWone has two master's degrees, one in counseling and another in psychology. He is currently in the process of finishing up his PhD in clinical psychology. He is the owner of Healthy Life Interventions Counseling in Oklahoma City, as well as his private practice, D. Bennett Counseling, here in Dallas, Texas. DeWone believes that the key to mental and behavioral success is the ability to master self-awareness and emotional control. And I say this all the time. I couldn't agree with you more. And so let's talk about this. So navigating relationships with opposing political views, how does that work? Because people have, I mean, there are different values to different political, views. And so how do values affect relationships?
And that's a good question, because that's exactly what it is. We're talking about someone who comes into a relationship with someone else who has different values. And sometimes in the beginning of relationships, those opposite views are not necessarily highlighted because you're focusing on strengthening
sex.
That relationship, right? Sex too, right? And so kind of... In my research, I found that 38% of married households contain are politically a mismatch, right? So that's 38%. So that's almost 4 out of 10.
Yeah.
And 1 out of 10 families are leaving their partners because of opposing political views. So this is obviously a hot topic, right?
Well, yeah, absolutely. Well, what is political incompatibility? Actually, and how does it affect relationships?
So it's essentially when your political values don't align.
Right.
And so when we're talking about values, we're talking about what's important, what's right or wrong, what matters to you most.
So an example, just so for people that, you know, a good example of that.
So a good example would be essentially someone who maybe feels that the right to choose, the right for choice is important, versus someone who feels like they may not want their wife to have a child, you know. So mm-hmm. I think when you're thinking about political views and your values, it crosses over into what do you fundamentally believe that's important.
Mm-hmm. Well, how can people overcome political differences in a relationship? I don't think it's possible, myself personally. I couldn't even imagine having some of those big issues and have an opposing view and living under the same roof and liking one another.
So first of all, active listening is important. So when you're trying to talk with somebody that you have a relationship with, particularly your partner, you want to make sure you get an understanding for why they feel this way and not be so rushed to feel like you need to respond or you feel like you need to mm-hmm. turn to a debate, because they may have a childhood experience that caused them to believe this fundamentally, and that's why the value is important to mm-hmm. them. So what we always say, active listening, so that's comprehension, retaining the information, and also trying to make sure that you're responding once you've got to understand it of what they're saying. So that's when we talk about mirroring. So that having the ability to mirror, you feel this is important to you because of what?
Well, yeah.
So those are key components.
Well, I'm a great listener. I really am. But I'm a great talker too. But
yeah, I was going to say, I feel like that's where everything politically goes down the toilet. Mm-hmm. People don't let someone finish the why behind why they believe a certain way, because people are so emblazoned or impassioned mm-hmm. or off the rails sometimes about their own opinion that they don't let someone get out. Well, this is why I feel
right.
this way.
Yeah.
And because of that, we don't have good discourse about it.
But even if you have an understanding, you're not going to change your value system.
Sure.
And so, gosh, I mean, so I asked the obvious question, can in a relationship with two people on different sides, is that politically is that possible?
Well, yes, it's possible. And I'll tell you why it's possible, because there are boundaries that that families can put in place. So one of the things is maybe they can say, hey, we're not going to watch any politics or news together, and we're not going to discuss these in our relationship. They have relationships where political discussions are something that they engage in. There's also ways, because we understand that everyone is different and people have the right to choose in their beliefs. They mm-hmm. have a right to. And so what I say is, do you feel like your partner's fundamental beliefs about their political beliefs or the way they run their life, do you feel like that prevents you guys from being able to be compatible and work together. Because in some instances, it may not. If we're talking about two people who are just on a different side of the fence, right? Somebody is maybe a Democrat and a Republican. That doesn't mean they're on two different extremes sides of the fence.
Well, you spoke of fence. It's so funny because just a minute ago, I was thinking a fence. How can you build a good relationship when there are fences that are up?
No, I mean, it just makes me wonder why we have to feel like it's a fence. Like, why we can't have, why can it be more like a flowing thing? Because I just wonder why there's such a divide, and that's the topic for another thing. Mm-hmm. But I think the fence is just an obvious, like, way we think of it. But why does it have to be that way? Why can't it be more flowing? And why can't, you know, when you said, how do people do this? And I just wanted to say love. Because love should transcend all of your opinions that you have. Mm-hmm. And so, you know,
yeah,
I'm not the expert in the room.
Well,
but,
yeah,
you know.
Absolutely. I'm a great believer in love. But I just think that when you have huge fundamental differences, some of them are just deal breakers. They just are.
And it goes into one person's contention, or some one person's convention could be another person's contention. And I think that's what it is. So when you're talking about your relationship and why values are so important, if you think about you're heading down a path of life, you want to be able to walk and hold the person's hand that you're with. But if you believe in, let's say, hypothetically, you want to live in New York and your partner wants to live in California, then how can you guys walk down a path of life and holding hands together when you have different values on what you want to do with your life? Mm-hmm. And that's why these issues can be so important. If you're talking about things like Roe versus Wade, then you're talking about something that is ingrained in someone's beliefs and how that affects you. If you're saying, hey, a woman shouldn't have the right to choose, but I believe that I should have the right to choose. What's my why? Why do I believe that? Mm-hmm. Why do I believe that? Because you don't know my history. Maybe I was sexually abused. Maybe my mother was abused. And she felt like she wanted to choose on what if she wanted to have the baby or not. Mm-hmm. So all those things are important. And when we don't have those discussions of why do you believe this, then we're missing the fact. Mm-hmm. Because then we can try to impose our views onto someone that we love unintentionally.
Well, I think we as a country need to open our minds and our minds in relationships as well, because this could actually be good for a couple in their family, right? And for the kids to see their parents be cordial and still have separate views.
The divergent in opinions is important because what it allows kids to do is see that, hey, we can disagree, but we can still love each other. Mm-hmm. We don't have to have groupthink. Amen. We have the ability to say, hey, you have your views, I have my views, but we learn to work together. Mm-hmm. And that's why I think that is important. I think for parents to have those open discussions with their children in areas that they disagree in, particularly politically and sometimes even religiously,
yeah,
those are very important because now it gives the kid who's in the middle who can say, I have the ability to think for myself and make the choice that's most in line with my beliefs and what I feel. Mm-hmm. So,
no, go ahead.
I was going to say, so I do feel that that's important as long as they're having that conversation.
All right. Just a couple of seconds here. Are there some real deal breakers?
There are some real deal breakers. And I believe when somebody attacks something that you fundamentally believe and we discuss like Roe versus Wade, then I think that can be a deal breaker because what you're saying is you disagree with my ability as a woman to choose for mm-hmm. myself and what I want.
Yeah. Interesting. DeWone, always a pleasure. Thank you so much, Jill. Thank you so much.
Great
love having
here.
You in studio. Everyone, I hope you enjoyed the show. We always enjoy doing it. We really do. You know what? You get one body, you get one mind, and you get one life, and you get one vote. So get out there today and take care of it.